Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Forensic Science India. Today again I am here with the topic document examination. So let's get started. So the topic which I am going to discuss today are build-up document, chart document, alteration, addition, eraser, obliteration and indented writing. So we will see them one by one. So build-up document. Build-up document are those which are considered legally non-genuine document as it bears the genuine signature of the signatory authority, but the whole document is not genuine. In such cases, the signature acquired from built signatory is not known to him. The author is not familiar with the content of the given document. Here, the signature of the signatory is genuine, but the document on which his or her signature present is fake or non-genuine document. Documents can be any will, power of attorney, agreement, property documents, etc. So in case of build-up document, someone maliciously add some kind of fake document in between the genuine document, and the authority or signatory have no idea about this thing, and he will, without knowing this purpose, he just signed the document. So the sign present on the documents are real, but in between those documents there is some non-genuine documents are also present. So those non-genuine documents on which the genuine signatures are present is known as build-up document. Let's move on. So how we can identify a build-up document? Number one, we can see the position of the signature on the given document. In such cases, the orientation or position of signatures are not up to the mark. Merging of the signature with the content. Unusual spacing and characteristics of the signatures. So position of the signature is not up to the mark. There might be some merging of the content with the signature. An unusual spacing can also be seen because if the document is made for some malicious intent, it might be made in some very less space, and the space is less, so the document content and signature might be merging with each other. So let's move on to the chart document. Chart document are those documents which are burnt to destroy the evidence. This is the most common act performed by the criminals to hide the evidence. Burnt documents do not remain usually in their original shape and get broken into small fragments. They may also get twisted around the edges, therefore handling of the chart document is a very important task. Chart documents may prove to be of great value if properly handled to keep them intact. So chart document is a document which is burned purposely to destroy the evidence. Okay, here you can see the image showing the chart documents. The chart piece of documents are collected with the help of cardboard and transported properly to the laboratory in a corrugated box. Here you can see a kind of box. Okay, so how we can say that this is a corrugated box? A corrugated box is a box which contains cotton layer, which further covered by tissue paper layer on which charred pieces of document are placed, which is again covered by tissue paper and subsequent layer of cotton in order to avoid any further damage to the burned document. So cotton layer, then tissue paper layer, then we will place the charred document, then again we will cover it with the tissue paper, then again with the cotton layer, and we will close the box. Now this is known as a corrugated box. Okay. So the charred piece of document once transported to the laboratory can be kept in unified chamber in order to gain some moisture, or piece of charred document can be placed on a glass plate on which solution of polyvinyl acetate can be added drop wise around the edges of the glass plate to make the document soft and stable. So as we know, as the document are burned, they become very light in nature, so they can get move here and there. Okay, so to stabilize them, we will use polyvinyl acetate and we will add it drop wise around the edges of the glass plate on which we will place our document so that the document becomes soft and stable. Other than that, we will use silver nitrate solution after treating the charred document with polyvinyl acetate. What AgNO3 will do? AgNO3 will create gray background, and writing with contrast colors such as black and blue will become prominent. We will be able to see black and blue writings with the help of AgNO3. You can also use infrared photography to make the document visible. So now, alteration. What we know about alteration on frequently overwriting or patching of the existing writing alters document. So we try to modify the writing or change the writing with the help of overwriting or patching is known as alteration or altering the document. Altering means we are changing the nature of the document with the help of some altering or modifiers or alters. It may also be made after eraser. The simple alteration can be detected under magnification when the stereoscopic binocular microscope is used with low power. It becomes apparent what has been altered because each pen stroke is distinguishable. Okay, so if we will see with the help of a stereoscopic binocular microscope, we will be able to magnify the image and we will be able to distinguish the altered pen strokes. Small differences in the color of ink used or the stage of writing may also be shown under the examination. The most common alteration are 1 to 0, 0 to 9, or so many. These are one of them. Documents are altered by means of addition, obliteration, and erasers. These are the method under alteration by which we can alter the document. So we will see them one by one. Addition. Documents are altered by means of addition. Adding is referred to the insertion of sentence, a word, letter to the small space between the lines or letters. An addition of this type can be detected by when it is written with a different pen or ink, when it is added by a different writer, when by its crowding or abnormal spacing it is apparent that it was not a part of the original, or when there is detectable difference in the age of writing. So addition is something we deliberately add in the document. What can be added? It can be a sentence, a word, a letter. Okay, it can be detected by several means which I have discussed above. So here you can see images which showing the letters, strokes, and numerals. Here you can see Miss M is added, Betty Smith, 1 is added in this check, and it was 6, but teen is added afterwards. So addition, here you can see, the stroke, it was 01, but a stroke is added to make it 04. So you can see the addition pattern, how addition can be done, and it can be identified. Now obliteration is meant as the effective destruction of appearance of the writing without actually removing it or rendering it invisible. Overwriting or crossing with a pencil, pen, or by spreading ink or dark fluid is the most common method. So obliteration is the destruction of appearance of writing. We hindered the writing appearance by with the help of pencil, pen, or dark fluids. Obliterated writing is deciphered by examination under strong light at various angles, particularly with transmitted light examination, with UV radiation or photography, with infrared rays, or examination under infrared image converter microscope. Treatment with chemical reagents which will remove the overwriting. If obliteration has been carried out with the same pen and ink soon after the writing, it is often difficult to read the original text. So with the help of UV radiations, infrared image converter microscope, we can be able to identify the obliterated documents. Other than that, we can use video spectral comparator. It is an equipment recently been developed to identify the obliterated document. This whole instrumental technique I will be discussing in the later on videos. So here you can see the images of document which are obliterated. You can see it is obliterated by a pencil shade, but with the help of VSC or different sources, we can identify or decipher the writing present below the obliterated document. Here you can see. Now erasers. One of the most common way to alter document is to try to erase part of it. It can be performed by mechanical and chemical means. Mechanical means a rubber eraser, sandpaper, razor blade or knife is used to remove writing by abrading on the paper surface. So, but with the help of this instruments like rubber eraser, paper razor blade, we can abrade the paper surface. Chemical means are like chlorine, bromine, water and sulfurous acid, which decolorizes the writing. Erasures can be deciphered by certain inks are soluble in solvent like H2O, alcohol and acetone. So this proper solvent can be used to identify or decipher the writings erased. Detergents can be used to remove certain ink, especially carbon inks. So we can also use detergent to see the erasures, to see the erased writing. So here you can see some images showing erased document. Here you can see the numeral 9-3. They are firstly erased and then overwritten over that. With the help of some instrumental technique, these are deciphered. And what was written behind or below this writings? Indented writing. When some matter is written on piece of paper underneath which there are other papers, the underlying sheet may contain indentation that, if deciphered, may reveal what was written on the top of the sheet. So if someone with with heavy pen pressure writes something on a paper, it get indented beneath the paper on some other papers. So the underlying sheet may contain indentation, which can be deciphered and reveal what was written on the top of the sheet. So in anonymous letters, indented writing assume great importance. Indented writings are detected and read by the following techniques. Examined under ordinary light with oblique illumination with the help of iodine, where the quantity of iodine vapors deposited varies at the place of indented writing and the rest of the surface. The contrast may reveal the writing. So iodine fumes can also be used to decipher the indented writing, to read the indented writing as well. Spreading graphite powder on the surface of indented writing. So if we spread a graphite powder on indented writing, we will be able to see the writing beneath the indentation mark. And more recently, electrostatic detection apparatus, ESDA, has been widely used for detecting indented writing. So this ESDA we will discuss in the later on videos. So here the images showing indented writings. Here you can see the due to pen pressure, the writings beneath the paper indentation marks are very prominently visible. And then with the help of ESDA and graphite and iodine fumes, we can able to decipher the writing present. So that's all for today. We will be coming with the instrumental techniques and case study in some other videos. So stay tuned, and if you like the video, please do subscribe to our channel. Okay, thank you so much for watching the video.